Can you consume protein drinks and protein bars on a ketogenic diet, providing you don't exceed your protein quota for the day? Well, ask yourself, why are you doing the ketogenic diet? Is it a quick fix? Do you want to lose weight quickly? Or are you doing the ketogenic diet to once and for all fix the metabolic damage you've caused throughout the years? If the answer is to fix your metabolic damage, then eating good food and fresh food is really the way to go. Fresh foods and good foods contain vitamins and minerals you cannot get from anywhere else, which actually aids in fixing metabolic damage. So by you opting to eat and drink protein bars and protein drinks, you're actually not giving yourself opportunity to eat these good foods that are going to help and aid in your weight loss. If you look at protein bars and protein drinks, you'll find that they contain protein isolates. Protein isolates are engineered to get into your system very, very quickly because of the phobia of what you call a catabolic state, where people are worried that their muscles are gonna waste away if they don't get protein quickly and quick enough into the muscle straight after a workout. Now, protein isolate may or may not, it's debatable, to suit an athlete. But for the common person like you and I that want to stay in ketosis and to lose weight, these will actually spike insulin. And insulin is the very hormone we want to keep low on the ketogenic diet because it's the gatekeeper to your fat cells. In addition, all these products also may contain, most of the time, branched chain amino acids. And they're exactly the same as protein isolates. They will also require an insulin response, again, which we want to be low on the ketogenic diet to burn as much fat as we can. Furthermore, you will also find that most of these products contain sugar replacements like sugar alcohols, which some of them, like maltitol, which I spoke about in my previous video, again spike insulin. You can see how this could be problematic from many point of view. The question is, why are you doing the keto diet? Is it to be healthy and to stop the weight gain problem forever? Or is it a shortcut and just a quick solution to lose a few kilograms for an event that's coming up? If you want to lose weight and keep it off, you're better off eating healthy, good food that is actually going to aid in your weight loss journey rather than to stop it. Protein isolates, branched chain amino acids may have a place in an athlete's life, but if you're a common person trying to lose weight and stay in ketosis, they're number one gonna prevent you from getting ketosis, and if you put in the effort and get in ketosis, they will take you out of ketosis again. My advice is to stay away from them at least until you reach your goal, and then once you're in the maintenance phase, you can start implementing and trialing with them and testing your blood sugar levels and your ketone levels to see if you have any kind of effect from them. So in summary, stay away from protein isolates, stay away from branched chain amino acids and casein. They will interfere in your weight loss journey. On my next video, I'll be giving you some tips on how to succeed and what successful people do when it comes to dieting and continuing the weight loss journey. I'll see you next time.